Interview. Today I'm talking with Bill Reid, President, CEO and Director of Gold Resource Corporation, listed on the over-the-counter bulletin board, OTCBB, in the United States. Stock ticker GORO, share price $4 US, market cap $137.67 million US. Gold Resource Corporation shares also trade on the Frankfurt Exchange, stock ticker GIH. Web address goldresourcecorp.com. So, Bill, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
Thank you, Harry. It's my pleasure.
Please give us a brief introduction to Gold Resource Corp, the company's business strategy, and what distinguishes Gold Resource Corp from its peers.
Thank you. I'd love to. Gold Resource Corporation was created to maximize shareholder value with a focus on cash flow and potential dividends. This company undertook its IPO in September of 2006. We did a self-underwritten IPO because we wanted to stay in control and to focus on having the fewest number of shares outstanding, so we have no warrants outstanding today. Our strategy is different than most. We make our decisions based on anticipated financial performance, not some arbitrary number like 1 million ounces in the ground or 3 million ounces of gold in the ground. We actually look at what is the capital expenditure to put this property into production, and then how long before we get our capital paid back. And so we have our own internal rate of 1 year or less. So we have to have the project pay itself back within 1 year or less. And this keeps us focused on very profitable, high-grade, low-cost operations. Our present project, our anticipated capital payback is 6 to 7 months. Another aspect of our company is the fact that we wanted to get into production at the earliest possible date so that we could build this company with cash flow and not go back to the equity markets every 6 months to sell more shares. So we have done enough drilling to justify putting this project into production, and that's what we're doing. We want to limit shareholder dilution by getting in production and building the company with cash flow because we have as our goal to distribute a meaningful dividend, and we want to do that with the fewest number of shares outstanding.
Tell us about the capital structure of Gold Resource Corp, Bill.
Today we have approximately 41 million shares outstanding. Approximately one-third are owned by management, which we feel is very important, as you'll see when we talk about our dividend policy. One-third by institutions and about one-third by retail. Now, two of our shareholders were very proud of our first Hochschild Mining. As we've mentioned, they're a mid-tier gold silver producer, and we have a good relationship with them. They own 15% of the company. And then Tocqueville Gold Fund, which is one of the most well-known funds out of New York. John Hathaway runs that fund. They own 15% of our company also, so we're very proud of that fact. So that's pretty much the capital structure.
Tell us about your flagship property, Aguila, in Mexico, and what is the plan for getting into production at Aguila?
Yes, this is very exciting. Our flagship property, our Aguila property in Oaxaca, state of Oaxaca, Mexico, we anticipate being in production mid-2009. I can't say exactly which month, but it will be soon. And we're in construction at the present time, and I actually leave this afternoon to go back down there, and it's absolutely thrilling to see all the continuing work from the last time I was there. And at this point in time, all the concrete work is done, and the structural steel and the buildings are going up, and we're starting to ship equipment to the project. So it's very exciting. As I said, we expect to be in production this year, and we're really looking at 75,000 ounces of gold the first year of production from our Aguila project, building up to 177,000 ounces in the third year.
What is the metallurgy like at Aguila, and how will the metallurgy impact the company's cash flows and the valuation of Gold Resource going forward, Bill?
This property has the best metallurgy I've ever seen in my history. We have multiple types of ore bodies. The first type is our gold and silver open pit that we'll be processing in the first 12 months. In a milling operation, we can grind to 150 mesh, which is not that fine, and in 48 hours, we achieve 90% recovery of the silver and 94% recovery of the gold. So that's very good. And as I said, we're going to produce 70,000 ounces of gold. The first year, we'll use the silver as a credit so that our cost to produce the 70,000 ounces of gold will be at $100 per ounce of gold. Then in our second year, we have our polymetallic deposit. Our polymetallic deposit is underground. It's very high grade. And in that deposit, we have not only gold and silver, but we also have lead, zinc, and copper. That requires a different process, which is flotation. But in these flotation concentrates, we're recovering approximately 94 to 95% of each metal. And this gives us the ability to say, because we have this copper, lead, and zinc, the revenue we get from those base metals we use as a credit against our costs, and actually gives us the ability to say we have zero costs because those base metals will pay for the entire operation. So our gold and silver, the gold and silver which we anticipate producing in the third year is targeted at 177,000 ounces gold equivalent at zero cost. So we know we have a very high-grade deposit. It's very exciting and with very low cost. And we think this, of course, will help our valuation on a going forward basis.
Tell us about Gold Resource Corp's project pipeline, Bill.
In the state of Oaxaca, we actually have four properties. The first is our Aguila property that we are building our mill at this point in time. But we have three other properties, and they're all high grade, with the ability to truck that high grade to this mill. So the concept is four properties feeding one mill. That's a very advantageous situation. Our second property, El Rey, is high-grade gold. We've been drilling that, and we have up to 1 meter of 4 ounces of gold, another meter of 2 ounces gold. So we expect to have a small underground mine there, primarily high-grade gold, and we can ship that to the mill also. We have two other properties, Las Margaritas, which is a high-grade silver property, and Salaga, which is a high-grade silver property, which we haven't done much work on yet. But once again, the focus has been to get El Aguila into production, generating the cash flow, and then we'll have the cash flow to explore the balance of these properties. So we have a very good pipeline of properties ahead of us.
What experience does the Gold Resource team have in finding and developing profitable gold mining projects, Bill?
Before Gold Resource Corporation, my brother and I founded our first gold company in 1977. That was U.S. Gold Corporation, and we ran that for 28 years. More importantly than our longevity was the fact that we put 6 mines into production. They were all in the United States. Then in 2005, we sold controlling interest in that company to Rob McCune of Goldcorp fame, and he took that company, and this allowed us to then go forward with Gold Resource Corporation and use our 30 years worth of experience to maximize value for the shareholders.
Hochschild Mining is a shareholder in Gold Resource and recently increased its stake. How is your relationship with Hochschild Mining?
Our relationship is very good. We're very pleased to have Hochschild as our strategic alliance partner. Hochschild today is a shareholder like any other shareholder. They own 15% of our company through a private placement. That private placement was at $3 a share, so we received $18 million, which is the balance of the money we needed to put this project into production. But Hochschild is an experienced company that's well known for their underground expertise, and the future of our project is certainly underground, so we expect a real alliance there, the possibility of helping us with our underground situation. Just to give you an example, Hochschild invited our geologist up to their open pit, the Morris Mine in Mexico, for a 2 to 3 week training to help our people understand ore control in the pit. And they came back very excited, learned a lot. And this, I think, is just another example of how we have a very positive strategic alliance with Hochschild.
What is Gold Resource Corp's financial situation, Bill?
Well, at this point, we believe we have enough money to get the project into production and start the cash flow, and that's what our focus is all about. We raised our initial production funding, $23 million, in December of 2007, and then we did this private placement just a couple of months ago with Hochschild for $18 million. And the project itself, we believe we're going to have it built for $25 million.
What can we expect from Gold Resource over the next 12 to 18 months, Bill?
Well, I think it's a very exciting time for this company. First of all, we're going to make the transition from an exploration company into a production company. And historically, when companies have made that transition, the marketplace has re-rated the company. So we're expecting that. We also have a very high-grade deposit with a lot of potential, and we will have continued exploration over the next 12 to 18 months, and we think we're going to be able to come out with some very exciting results. nobody can really argue that we have world-class grades. We do have world-class grades. And then secondly, we believe we have a world-class geologic setting. So the only question is, well, how big is this deposit? And